Hey, it's me, Persephone. There's a company that I became aware of called ShopLC. This is not a sponsored video, by the way. Just, you know, a little disclaimer. This is not sponsored. And it came in the box. Oh, it'd be nice for me to mention what it is. It is a musical LED speaker box light bulb with Bluetooth remote. Sounds fancy. But, you know, ShopLC, baby. Delivering joy. That sounds like a fantastic tagline for your company. Okay. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I was trying to retrieve my scissors, but I didn't do it very elegantly. So, yeah. And what's funny was I was starting to open it up as I was walking out of the post office. And then I said, hey, why don't I film an unboxing video? That's kind of how that idea came. So, literally, this is like on the fly. Order slip. Because of the nature of the product that I ordered, this is what the packaging looks like. And then in the box, this is what it looks like. LED music bulb. And it has all the specs on here. Very intrigued. Anything that's Bluetooth, I automatically love it. It's 100 watt? Good God. Okay, so... So this is what it looks like coming out of the package. Okay, and it has the remote. Little insert. It just has some basic information on it. Ooh, praise the Lord Jesus. The battery for the remote. I don't know whether you can see it, but it says it is included. That alone makes me love this product. Just because it's like, you know what? Life is hard enough without you having to worry about a battery. We're gonna, you know, the first one's on us. And it has a little tab here. I'm gonna take that out in a second. But yeah, you take it out and it looks like just a very large floodlight light bulb. And then it has the speaker. Okay, so I have a lamp here, and I am going to turn this off. Okay, it's on. Did you hear that? That's the chime letting you know that the Bluetooth is ready to go. Oh, okay, the remote works. As you can see, here we go. On. Hey, off. Okay, on, off, on, off. Okay, I guess I have to turn it more towards me. On, off. Still a little, you got to really make sure you hit that button a certain way. On, off, on. Okay, let's try some colors. Oh, flash. Oh, it's looking so pretty. Inch, 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 inch. Man, any inch, 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 inch. Okay, strobe. Strobe. Are you gonna do some stuff? Okay. Okay, it's slowly changing color. Okay. Because it was green and blue and purple and pink. Very pink. My God. Orange and green and blue. Okay. And then that's white. Very bright. I like how bright it is. Oh, and you can adjust the brightness. Hold the phone. Okay, that's, ooh, Jesus. That's like dentist bright. Okay. Okay. So it has like 1, 2, 3, 4 levels of brightness. That's pretty good. And then you have it where it just turns red. And then you have it where it just turns blue. Just green. Just red. And then you got orange, and you got, okay, you got purple. Okay, I see you light. Here's the thing about the colors. The yellow isn't really yellow. It's like a, it's almost like a lemon lime kind of situation. It's like a, like a, like a creamy lime color. Some of these buttons. Okay, so I guess there's a darker blue. I guess there's like a light, not as bright blue, and a bright blue, and the same kind of color blue, orange sherbet, and like fluorescent orange. And then there's lilac. I don't want to say purple because that's not purple. Purple's my favorite color. I'm an expert, obviously, on purple. So, that's not purple. That's more like a cute, lilac-y kind of situation. The blue is really pretty. It's a really pretty, like, neon kind of blue. And then the green is the same. Now, these buttons on the second row here, those colors are more vibrant. That red is more vibrant. That green is more vibrant. That blue is more vibrant. And obviously the white is the most vibrant of them all. And then I like the fact that you can control the brightness of the white. Can y'all see? I can see it as a reflection on my skin. I hope y'all can see it too. About the Bluetooth. Let me go to grand old iTunes here. What do I have in iTunes? Beyonce. Let me see. Because I deleted some music off of my iPad because I needed room. And I had Jesus music on here too. Let's not, you know, let's not. What the French toast? Let me turn this fan off so you can hear it. Okay, the sound is pretty, Y'all old heads, y'all already know what song this is, but I'm gonna let the... Hey! Alright, okay. Why does the song have such a long intro? I mean, I know that's how they do it, but... How can I love somebody else if I can't love myself enough to know when it's time to let go? Mary was telling y'all some stuff. Oh, let me put that mood light in. Hold on. Because on here, the buttons are for two different things at the bottom, so I have to make sure. So if I'm going for the volume, do I hold it down? Okay. On the bottom here, you have the volume, next song, volume, previous song. Well, yeah, volume, previous song, volume, next song, and then play, pause. So that's pause and play. And play, okay. For the volume, you have to hold it down. It's kind of loud. Okay. Okay, Mary. went back into the 90s for a second. Okay. But as you can see, as you can hear, actually, that music is very loud.
I can't find...
That was disrespectful, because I didn't know you were going to start like that. We're going to turn this down just a smidgen. No! You really got to hold that button down to get the volume to go. Wait! This remote is giving me a little trouble, but I still like it. But it's giving me a little trouble. Like, out of 10, I give this remote a 7.5. And dropping. Could they have possibly added a few more buttons at the bottom to make my life a little bit easier? Possibly. Would that have increased the price of the product? Absolutely. Would I still have purchased said product if there had been the extra little convenient button chip on the bottom? More than likely, because I like things that are user friendly. Mike, I'm gonna need you to Michael. I'm trying to turn the volume down. You gotta hold it. Okay, I'm gonna have to turn it down on the device. That thing is loud. Okay, that is a plus. I did not expect it to be that loud. Do you hear how loud it is? Listen. God. I need to see, because there are a lot of Bluetooth speakers, even USB speakers, that don't carry bass very well. And I mean, they say you get what you pay for, but there are a lot of inexpensive things that I have purchased that have worked beautifully, and there are a lot of expensive things that I have purchased that have worked horribly. So I want to take the price out of it, because that really doesn't matter. Okay. Let me see if it responds.
Bring the beat in.
A little bit of bass was kind of... Wait. You really... Look, I can't listen to 1+1 right now. I'm too emotional. No! No! It would have been nice if you just stopped right there on beat. I don't like the remote. I mean, the remote for the lights is okay. It's pretty responsive when it comes to the lights. Now, I have it where it's facing towards me pretty well. I just changed it, you know, just adjusted it again. It's responding for the lights. Okay, so I'm turning it down. Turn that back up. And turn it back down. Now it works when I want to go back to the beginning of the song. Okay, now it's... So, I can't adjust the volume in the middle of the song? And the pause button is... There's lag in the pause. And there's lag in the... Why is there such lag? I'm like right here by the light. Okay, there's a delay. That's what it is. It's a delay, and I'm not sure whether that's just a design flaw or whether that's, I don't know what it is. I mean, the light is right here. Like, let me show, the light is like right there. So I don't know why it's taking so long to respond for certain things, because when I use the remote control for the lights, it works fine. So I'm playing the music again. Okay. Did you see that? Like, it does the strobe thing, and then when you turn the music on, it gets a little clubby. Now, see, it's the light itself is what gets me. Oh, go back. Yeah, go to end of time. Go to end of time. Go to end of time. I see what you're doing. I see what you're doing. Hey, Beehive. Okay. Let me turn up a little bit. Okay. Okay, that's a little high. I really like how the light responds to the music. Okay. I don't understand why it's... Maybe it's just because it's cheap. Maybe, possibly. I don't know. All right. All right, Mrs. Carter, pause. But I know.
1 + 1 = 2. And it's me.
I'm pushing the ball. That is going to take my overall score. Okay, because if I'm scoring just the speaker alone, out of 10, I think I would give it a 10 for loudness. I would give it a 6.5 for the ability to translate the bass and for you to be able to hear the subtle nuances. And of course, yes, I am taking into account the price of the speaker, but I still, no matter how much you pay for something, you still want it to do a specific thing. When it comes to the overall look and design, it's pretty high up there. I mean, I give it a 9. I don't really think there's anything else that could be done with it aesthetically. It looks like a traditional floodlight bulb, but it has the head of a speaker. So it's fine with me. This little thing right here, I don't like. Now, when it comes to the lights, it's good. It's good. They could have just done with the flash. Because the strobe is okay. The strobe and the fade are very similar. So it was really no reason for there to be another button there. And the smooth. If it just had flash and smooth, because it has flash, strobe, fade, and smooth. If it just had flash and smooth, I would be happy. Because what they could have done was just put flash and then smooth, and then had a separate up and down volume set of buttons. Are y'all listening? When you do your next generation of this, forget about the strobe, forget about the fade. Just do flash and smooth, and then do volume up, volume down, and then do previous song, next song, pause and play. Another thing, you don't need all these colors. Okay, because there's not much of a difference. The biggest difference is the red, the green, the blue, the white, and the purple, the lilac. You know, you can say that is a significant difference in color. But this crap y'all got going on, but this lemon lime sorbet color, y'all could have kept that. And this, like, barely tropical peach you got going on, I could have done without that. And the very minute changes in the purple color. There's 24 buttons on here. y'all could have done without 12 of them. The buttons could have been bigger, and maybe that would have made them more responsive. The remote needs work. The remote, I give a 3 out of 10. Because there's a lot of unnecessary stuff going on here. I'm very disappointed with the remote. Very disappointed with the lag and the inability to comfortably change the volume without having to worry about messing up the groove. Say I'm dancing the end of time and I'm getting it. And you want to turn it down just a smidgelet? But it's at the you get towards the end of the song where you're really about to tear it up. That breakdown, you about to kill it. It's you trying to turn it down just a little because you don't want to disturb anybody. You turn it down just a little bit and you go back to the beginning of the song. Has that ever happened to you? You've been at a party and everybody knows you got the moves and you've been ready to just break it down with the actual choreography from the song, from the actual song, and it skips to the beginning of the song. Like, imagine the embarrassment that would cause. Like, y'all need to think about that now. Come on. Fix this. I love that y'all included the battery. That's cute. I appreciate you for that. I do not feel like it's worth the money. I feel like you could just get a strobe light that actually does strobe light things and just use a regular speaker. To have a 2-in-1 is a great idea. It's a fantastic idea. But the remote is so wonky. Actually, when I see remotes like this, I usually kind of roll my eyes anyway because I already know that whenever you go to push the button, it's really not going to respond very well. Like, I just push the button. And you, that's all we'll have when the world is through. Not even Beyonce can make me feel better right now. See how it lagged? Yeah, overall, I give this LED music bulb, overall, a 5. A 5. I could have done without the hassle and the foolishness. Now look at these people on the box. They look like they're having the best time. They're just living their best life. They're just wild and crazy fun times. No, that's not what I feel. I mean, yes, I was jamming to Mary J. Blige. Yes, I was jamming to Beyonce. Yes, I had my little moments, you know. But overall, I have a speaker system right here that works perfectly well that I can use. And I could just use the strobe light and use the light effects on the bulb. I'll leave the bulb in there. I have my other bulb here, but I'll leave the bulb in there. It's not hurting nobody. And leave the remote by my bed. But I had higher hopes for it. This remote really took it down. Because if the remote had worked the way it was supposed to, I would have given it a much higher score. I would have given it probably about a 9. I'm working on a 4.5. Every time I try to play it, it's like the score goes down like a half a point. So I'm going to stop at 5. I hope you guys enjoy this because it was a little stressful for me. My ear almost got blown out a couple times. If I had to order this again, I wouldn't. I'm going to go eat a salad and hopefully feel better about life. And I'll talk to you guys later. Okay? Love you. Bye.